Cuba. I mean, I've actually had that moment bad. Which is pretty gross. Here's something about them.
And a neat little audio guide.
Unless you're starving to death, that ain't nothing but a vegetarian sandwich.
Is it?
There's no meat on it.
It makes me sad. Children's audio tour. Is this a way? Are there more numbers here?
Oh,
that would be cool, yes.
It's bright out here.
For being overcast, anyway. This is a nice shot of the church. Get a picture of that. Roman statues. Can we zoom in really close?
Sorry.
Oh, sorry. It's a bit bouncy there.
Put stones outside of water. You set them down. Maybe they had scuba divers. They had scuba divers.
Yes.
With oxygen tanks. Ancient Roman oxygen tanks. I suppose. I'm a bit stretched.
Subject to my close personal supervision.
Will you do any yourself?
I'll do all the finishing. For God's sake.
There's no numbers anywhere. What am I supposed to put in this thing? What's number two, tell me?
I see a 29.
Oh. 85. Okay.
85.
Yep. Oh, sorry.
It's all right, thank you. Just moving a bit easier if you can. Cleaning.
Once a luxurious hot swimming pool, it was built by the Romans soon after the invasion of Britain back in 1843. They wanted to make their new home as much as possible like their old home, complete with public buildings, temples and bathhouses. But for most of the 2,000 years they've been here, Roman baths beneath their feet have been hidden. The Romans left, each generation is built on top of the ruins so that, on the higher, ancient buildings were left buried far below. Oh, look. I see water flowing. You see it? Maybe not. I can see it from here. The Roman baths themselves were discovered. I could go over all of that with you, but frankly, it's moderately tiring. It's like the Joker.
Sorry.
It's like the chemical bath the Joker fell into when he became the Joker. Most of us do know, however, how hot springs work. Oh, this is a shot to the hot spring. Oh, you can see the bubbles. See the bubbles? It's from the hot spring. Cool. Very, very cool. Britain, our hot springs adorned with sumptuous splendor for use of mortals. Minerva is patron goddess of bees. Salinas, the 3rd century. Museum stuff. Sorry. Aqueduct. Stone. Consulship of Emperor Vespasian, 7 years after the Emperor in 69. So, look, full three dimensional. Down and six stream drops from the top. This feels like a different bar. Lovely. This is number 47. This model shows how this art looked in the 4th century. This time, the color of the rooms, the size was breathtaking. Huh. Let's do a little circle about. Additional mortary stone there to secure the bit. Mm-hmm. Look at these trinkets. Okay, there we go. These are toothpicks. Perhaps matches. It's unclear. There. Bracelets, keys, other ancient Roman bits. so choose. Look at all the Roman coins they found. Of a zoom zoom.
Two, chapter four.
courtyard. Here we go. Okay, so we're on our way to the temple courtyard. How lovely. If a bit disconcerting. Ancient stonework. Certainly has an intriguing smell. Smells of situated. Smells very strongly. Old water. Probably cut. Oh, look. The head of Sulis Minerva. Said it was once part of a statue of Syrinscape Minerva, caused the secret spring. Huh. Once would have worn a big helmet, etc. etc. Okay. Please. Have added all the texture would have been looks like on the original. That's cool. Temple. Focus sometimes. We are daughters of places where great streams burst suddenly from hidden sources. We honor springs of hot water as divine. The sacred spring. Sherwood. Messages to the gods. Pewter pottery. Related to that. Made a lot of crazy lead poisoning and the like. Oh, hey. The coast is still to the hot springs. You can see bubbles. Perhaps, if you're close enough. wonder how hot the water actually is.
No,
it's in the 12th century, the king's bath was built within Roman ruins. I'll take a picture of that and read it later. I always pause the video and read it to yourself in a bit. Oh, he needs a mockingjay in there. You have a mockingjay pairing, I would say. Roman brooch to be probably from Ireland. Very coins. Stacks and stacks of coins. Can't really get in there. That's alright. Show you the stacks of coins, which are at the moment, of course, rather priceless. And of these gold coins, the lectures were thrown in together. Coins, oh, coins from the spring. People would actually throw coins in the spring, like they do now. Very much so, like they do now. This way. No exit. Elevator. Got a bit more of a stone. And down we go. Ooh. Shop. Pulley system. This, of course, is now we will have lifted stones. This is this down. Why don't we showcase this a bit? Can. So this has, everyone has one pulley. Alright, that means it is much harder to pull. This one has, you'll notice, three pulleys, and is much easier. The trouble is, the more pulleys you have, the more rope you have to pull. Right? Thus, it's easier to pull. Get it. There you go. Yeah. And then this one's much easier to pull. That one you should be able to do one-handed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The more rope you have going up and down with the pulley system, the more weight is distributed throughout the rope. Engineering. Engineering, yes. Yes. Oh, tools and things. Perhaps using lead. Again, very likely the cause of why the Romans were a bit loopy, using lead and everything. Oh, boy. This is part of the flowing water. You see the steam.
Steam rising from the flowing water.
Very lovely. Lots of people. Okay. Goodness. And I think I'm actually almost done. I do want to go into this shop for a bit, take a look, and then we'll take one more look over here. I think this goes outside to the bobs. We were up there. Now, of course, we are down here. It's very interesting and yet crazy. So we're going to be back in a little bit. Later!